So you get your blood work back from your doctor and you find out your LDL levels are fine. But here's the truth. People die of heart attacks every day that have normal to good LDL levels. In this video, I'm going to break down what LDL is, what it doesn't tell you about your heart disease risks, and the tests that you need to get that actually do tell you the risks you need to know. So first, let's break down what is LDL and what does a standard LDL test actually measure? So your body has several different types of cholesterol, two main types, an LDL and an HDL. LDL is typically categorized as the bad cholesterol. Now, that is because LDL is really the type of cholesterol that leads to deposition in the artery wall, which is the process of plaque formation. HDL has sort of the opposite effect, and we'll talk about that in another video. Some of the benefits of HDL, I believe, are a little bit overblown, but that is a topic for a separate conversation. Just remember that LDL is the type of cholesterol responsible for plaque formation and heart disease development. So, what does a standard test measure? Because we've all seen our standard lipid panel where there's a cholesterol level, an LDL level, an HDL level, and a triglyceride. And what you'll notice on that test is after LDL, there's a little dash and a little number, a little letter C. And that C doesn't mean count, it means calculated, meaning that they don't actually count the direct amount of LDL that's in your blood. They do a calculation based on the numbers of the other parts of your lipid panel. And what it gives us is an estimated weight of how much LDL is in a given volume of blood by weight. Now, that sounds like a great idea, but there's a huge area where that falls short because LDL risk and your risk of heart disease is oftentimes dictated by the size of your LDL and how many they are. So let's think about a little analogy here. Imagine a scale, like the scales of justice, right? Where you have a little basket on each side of a scale and you have 5 pounds of gold. Okay, and in one side of the scale, your 5 pounds of gold is made up of three big chunks of gold nuggets. And on the other side of the scale, you have 5 pounds of gold, but it's made up of 100 tiny little gold pellets. Both sides have 5 pounds of gold, but one side has far more particles of gold than the other. Now, if you're one of these people where your LDL concentration is made up of a lot more small particles than a few large particles, your risk of heart disease is much, much higher for a couple reasons. Number one, those small LDL molecules can slip through the artery wall much easier than the big large ones. The big large ones kind of bang around inside of the artery and they don't get through, whereas the small ones sneak through. The other issue is that just by sheer volume, having that many particles going through the bloodstream, they're more likely to have what's called shear or hemodynamic stress against the inside of the artery, which just means they're banging up inside the artery, which causes injury, and again, more likely drives them through the artery wall. So that makes a huge difference, and your typical LDL test on your blood work will not tell you the particle size or the amount. So you may have one person with an LDL of 115 that's just made up of a few large LDL particles and they have very low risk, whereas you may have another person whose LDL is also 115, but it's composed of all these small LDL particles, meaning they have much higher risk. So hopefully you can see from that example how that test doesn't really give us the true picture. So what do we need? Well, there's two tests that very accurately or more accurately measure LDL. One is called the LDL-P or the LDL particle number. Now, this test is done on something called an NMR lipid profile, which stands for a nuclear magnetic resonance. It's sort of like a MRI of your blood a little bit. And it actually is able to count the specific amount of particles in a given volume of blood. So this is very important because now we're getting to know how many are floating around. The other really neat thing that the NMR does is that it breaks down all of your lipid subclasses to tell you the size of your LDL molecules. Do you have a lot of little tiny ones or do you have big fluffy ones? And that is a very advantageous way to understand what our risk looks like. Now, NMRs are a little bit of a more specialized test. Not all doctors are familiar with them. All major labs do run them, like Quest and LabCorp. And from my experience in my clinic, most insurances will pay for them. So that is a great test to ask for and a much better way to understand your true risk when it comes to your LDL. Now there's a newer test that is out that's also very useful called an ApoB. Now an ApoB test is also a great way to measure the number of LDL particles in your blood. And how they do this is that every single LDL molecule, whether it's a tiny small one or whether it's a big giant one, every single one has one ApoB protein on it, exactly one ApoB protein. Your body cannot make any type of LDL without an ApoB protein on it. So if we just measure the ApoB counts, which are very easy and inexpensive to do, we can get a super precise reading of exactly what your LDL particle count is within your blood. And most experts will agree that just from a standpoint of cost and availability and accuracy, an ApoB is the most accurate thing you can get related to a cholesterol test to help you predict your future heart disease risk. So those are two very important differentiations. Now, knowing your risk does not stop at your LDL, and it's not wrapped up in how high is your HDL, which I already alluded to. Inflammation is oftentimes the silent killer associated with heart disease, because once cholesterol goes through your artery wall and sort of enters into a more danger area, it really has to do with the process of inflammation and oxidation that drives that cholesterol into a plaque. So inflammatory markers are a huge component to heart disease development. And we know some people can have relatively good LDL levels, even measured on an LDL-P or an ApoB, but very high inflammatory levels. And that will drive their heart attack risk through the roof. So some of the most important tests for inflammation are something you may have heard of called a HSCRP, or a highly sensitive CRP, or what's called a cardiac CRP. Something called myeloperoxidase is another inflammatory marker that is specific to plaque formation, in addition to something called LPPLA2. These tests offer a window into understanding your inflammatory picture, specifically related to heart disease risk, which really starts expanding out your knowledge of understanding what your heart risk actually is. Now, if you're going into your doctor, ask for an NMR profile or an ApoB. ApoBs are inexpensive and very often covered by insurance. And if you want an inflammatory profile, you can ask for the HSCRP, the myeloperoxidase, and the LPPLA2. Now, I know it's a lot of phrases and letters and everything I'm jumbling around, so that's why I wrote an ebook specifically on this topic. In my ebook, I go through the exact cardio test that I run on patients in my clinic, and I go through the exact mechanism of why we measure them, what they test for, and not only do I give just the reference ranges, but I give, more importantly, the optimal ranges of where you want to see these numbers for optimal risk reduction and to truly understand what your cardiovascular disease risk is. It's a 17-page guide, and it spells it all out in that book. So that's a great resource if you want to learn more about this. So thank you so much for listening. I hope you enjoyed the video, and please subscribe or like or share this video with somebody else that you think might benefit from it.